What is up, guys? Today we're at a tiny house Airbnb. I'm gonna be giving you guys a tour of this place. I think you guys are gonna love it. It's very beautiful and very minimalistic. So let's go check it out. So when you walk in, you're greeted to a very spacious living area with great natural light. If you look right here, window, window, window. There's three windows in this tiny little area for plenty of light and plenty of coziness. But probably the most beautiful part about this entrance is the bookcase that wraps around this door. I think it's very beautiful and very homey. It has a homey feel, you can decorate it with anything. As we move on, there's a day bed in here. I don't think there's enough room for a whole couch, a whole living area, but that's okay because you're living in a tiny house and that's what it's supposed to be like. But there is enough room for a day bed, for chilling, for sleeping, for doing anything you want in there. And if you wanted to put a TV or something in here, there's plenty of wall space in the TV. If you come back this way, you can see you're greeted with plenty of coat rack for hanging up your purses, hanging up coats, or anything like that. There's no central air in this place, which makes sense because it's a tiny house on wheels. So what they've done is they put in a window air conditioning unit and it cools the place in a matter of minutes. So as you move on down the place, you next have your fridge. Now when I first walked in here, I thought this fridge might be a little small, but as you open it up, it has a freezer and a mini fridge. It has plenty of room for anything you need, especially if you're just by yourself. And it's very beautiful, very retro looking. It fits the vibes perfectly in here. Next, you can see the little dining table area, the seating area. If you want to sit here and do some work, you can. If you want to sit here and do any eating or talking to somebody, you can. It's honestly a very large desk for a tiny area that this might be and might feel like, but it feels very huge to me. It feels very good. I don't feel cramped. I don't feel small at all. I feel like this has plenty of space to do anything at. So as you move along the back of the home, we're first greeted with this gas stove. It fits the vibes that we saw with the fridge, and it has plenty of room to do any cooking you want on here, especially for a single person or two people. There's plenty of room to do anything. You can open it up and there's the oven. It can fit any pan you want. Cookies, anything you want in there. So as you move back along, we're greeted with the kitchen and the countertop area. Honestly, there's plenty of room here to do anything. If you want to cut some stuff right here or here, if you want to set any dishes there, clean some dishes, this is plenty of space. And the sink, I've seen a lot of tiny houses and the sink is normally pretty small. This is a full-size sink with full-size faucet and everything with a little beautiful window right here. We can turn the lights on, but I like it better with the lights off. And you can see even over here has plenty of room for a microwave. Fits the vibes of the home very well. If we took a look right behind me though, you can see that they left exposed cabinets for their dishes, and it's honestly a decoration piece and it's very beautiful. You can fit all your dishes just right behind you. You don't have to worry about any countertop space or anything. Now what they have below the countertop is all their cooking utensils. They have all their paper towels and cleaning utensils for the dishes. And this is just a lot of storage for a place that is this small, but very spacious on the inside. If we keep going back, this place offers bedding for multiple people. As you can see behind me, there's a little nook of a bed. It's very comfortable, it's very cozy. And there's even a little window back there. You can turn on the light back here as well. It's a perfect spot for a single person sleeping. And what they have under the bed is plenty of storage for anything big, anything that you can't have out in the open. That's just too obvious and big. You can store it right under here. And if you wanted, you could even put a little door here. You can put a little curtain there to hide that, but it's plenty of storage for anything you need and have that might be a little bit too big. Now what we have behind the sink is a sliding barn door that opens to the bathroom. Now a lot of you might be curious about the bathroom. Let me just hop right in here. So I'm inside the bathroom. There's only room for about one person in here. I'm inside the shower actually. It's a full circle shower. I can close these curtains and I'm ready for my little shower. There's not really any walls in here, but it's just enough room for one person. So what we have on the other side is a composting toilet. It's pretty typical for all tiny houses. It's very easy to use. It doesn't stink or anything and it doesn't bother me at all. The shower is very cozy. Hot water, cold water, whatever you want. So now we're back out in the living area and we're gonna go to the loft. It's greeted with this ladder. It's pretty stationary. There's grips on it. But now you're probably wondering about your closet. There's a hanger right here for anything you need to hang up. It's kind of small, but for me, I don't have a lot of clothes to hang up. So it's perfect for somebody like me, for somebody that wants to be a little bit more minimal. But let's head up to the loft. So we made it up here in this loft. This is one of my favorite spots in this whole place. I climbed up the ladder and greeted with a queen size bed. Yes, this place can fit a queen size bed. There's plenty of space for you or another person or just by yourself or whatever. There's two elongated windows on each side to allow in plenty of natural lighting. What these people have done, they've installed little lamps also on the side for lighting in the nighttime. And whenever I'm laying in this bed or sleeping in this bed, I don't have to worry about hitting my head up whenever I rise up and sit up because there's plenty of headspace up here. So I don't have to worry about waking up in the morning and hitting my head. It's very easy to get up and down from here. And like I said, this is one of my favorite spots. It has a lot of room, plenty of stuff to do whatever you want up here. So that's the tiny house. Very beautiful, very minimalistic. The natural lighting is great. The aesthetic is great. If you like this, I'll leave a link down in the description of the Airbnb. It's only $55 a night. Super cheap. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to my channel for more like it. Share this video if you think this tiny house is beautiful. And leave a comment on what your favorite part of this tiny house was. And guys, I will see you Friday.